thank you. Good afternoon. So my name is Majdi. I'm an engineer and I'm from Tunisia. I'm co-founder of VAKAY Eyewear, which is a premium handmade wooden sunglasses. What is particular in VAKAY is that we don't only design our sunglasses, but we also manufacture them in our own workshop in Tunisia. And the title of my talk today is which is better, a good idea or a good team? Because for long years I was looking for the good idea to start my own business. And 3 years ago, I had a deep discussion with my co-founders. At the time they were friends, just friends, and then we started talking about handcraftsmanship in Tunisia, and we had a lot of concern about this topic, because in Tunisia we have a lot of heritage of skills of handcrafted objects, like from pottery, jewelry, and crafted shoes. But unfortunately, with floods of products that are imported, with especially from Asia, with a bad quality and low prices, a lot of craftsmen are losing their jobs. At the same time, we noticed that we had no eyewear industry in Tunisia, and for us it was bizarre. But because when we started to compare to the textile industry, for example, in Tunisia we have big companies that produce for high-end brands, and those products are sold in Europe and everywhere in the world. So we tried, was thinking to combine all these ideas, and maybe with the hand men's craft, and with with innovating in eyewear and design, maybe we can do something interesting. And Soulaimen said maybe it's to product designer to make this kind of product and think about the process. And at that moment, Adam asked him and challenged him. If Soulaimen is a talented designer, maybe he could make for him a personalized pair of wooden sunglasses. Actually, Adam wanted those pairs for him because he couldn't afford at that time a pair of wooden sunglasses, because he was still a student. But Soulaimen took it very seriously, and we went together to buy some rudimentary machines. And after a few weeks, he came back with what was the first prototype of VAKAY eyewear. And we were really impressed, because already it was a good product. And what surprised us more, that our friends asked Soulaimen to make for them also a pair of sunglasses. So we said, maybe it's an opportunity. So we started to study different processes possible to make the wooden sunglasses, comparing quality, capacity, etc. And also we started to study the market. We went to optician, and also we already think about the name of the brand. And Ashraf Yashini, our friend, came with the name VAKAY, which means it's in Vietnamese, and it means "and the tree," because we already had a vision and to combine a lot of materials with wood. We one day in an optician, we met by chance a famous Tunisian radio presenter, and he saw our sunglasses. He started to ask questions. He took a picture and wrote a small article on the internet. It was unexpected, but a lot of people were asking questions if they are really made in Tunisia. And he invited us in his in the radio, it made a big buzz. So we said, maybe it's time to launch our eyewear. So we worked days and nights in Soulaimen basement to prepare our first collection. And after 3 weeks, we made only a measly production of 12 sunglasses, But we already announced the launch of VAKAY, so we have to go on the market. And so this was the day of the launch. We were smiling, but at the same time, we had a lot of problems to solve. We have a measly production, we have to buy machines, we have to think about marketing and sales. So we had a lot of challenges. And so the first thing we think to do was to raise funds. So, so we go to the banks. We ask it for as it makes a buzz, and we were maybe in the bubble. We think that we will sell a lot of these pairs of sunglasses. So we saw things in big. We asked it for a big amount of money. And we had very optimistic hypotheses. But at that time, bakers start to ask us questions about how can you sure to sell this quantity? How will you deal with SAV, for example? And in reality, we didn't have answers to all these questions. But it was interesting because we realized that actually we are a startup and we are dealing with uncertainty in a lot of points. So instead of looking for a big amount of money, we said maybe we have to start small and keep our dreams big. So we said maybe we need only a few thousand dollars to experiment and to put our product in the market. And that's what we did. So we asked our friends and family to give us a small amount of money, and I'm sorry. As our first customers were eager to have their pair of sunglasses, they were okay to pay us in advance and to wait for our sunglasses months. But what they didn't know that we used this money to buy our raw materials and to invest also in the process of manufacturing. The first thing we need at that time is what we realized that making wood sunglasses was a good idea because a lot of people wanted our product, but this was a singular idea. And now we need a lot of ideas in order to manage with manufacturing, design, and marketing, etc. So first, we need a team. And so our team, Soulaimen Ghorbel, is a product designer, very talented, and he's also by training an industrial designer. Adam is a CPA. Ashraf Shishini, he's a product designer, and at that time he had already a lot of awards like a Red Dot and Design, and me, I'm an engineer. But what more important than talented individuals is that we need a good team that is cohesive, complementary, and also dedicated to VAKAY. So we all resigned from respective jobs and became dedicated to VAKAY. Also what was interesting that as we are engineer, product designer, industrial designer, and CPA, we have different backgrounds and different experiences. Actually, this helped us to tackle different problems from different points of view and connect different ideas. And I think that's what makes us creative in different situations. So first, we decided to outsource the main steps of the process that needs expensive machines. So, for example, we went to a signature company to make the laser cut. We went to a carpenter to cut the wood. We made PVD treatment in a ceramic manufacturing, and we cut the lenses in the opticians. A lot of people actually helped us. For example, local company helped us to make special organic varnish for our sunglasses. And we, in our own workshop, we focused on the handcrafted things. So, for example, we made this. We built this sander machine in order to have a very precise thickness of the wood in 10th millimeters. We also start to build our own tools like these molds. And what was interesting, as we started to sell our products in opticians, we had a feedback loop from customers. We knew that our quality problems that we have to improve. And for example, from wood molds, we went to these aluminium molds because we can control this temperature and it's more stronger. Also, we built a machine in order to make the shape of the nose, because what we learned from opticians that what is more important in the eyewear is that they have to be comfortable, and the most important thing is the shape of the nose. So we designed and tested a lot of shapes finally to get the right one. Also, for example, we changed our process from cutting in laser at the beginning, then to the glue different layers. Because when you glue these layers, they can slide. We standardized our semi-finished product, and also and after we had to shape it with the CNC. But as we don't have money to buy the CNC, we find an old pantograph machine that we repaired, and after we adapted to our process. Also, as higher our capacity was, we think to start to experiment our products in abroad of Tunisia. So for example, we started with Paris, then Geneva, London, and what we learned from this client that people who are looking for creators, sunglasses, they don't want to have the brand like we had engraved on their arms. So instead, we designed a new logo inspired from the Berber alphabet, which the V and A of VAKAY, and we made it in wood, and it was more discreet and more beautiful. And after we renewed the stock in our opticians, and we had good feedback from sales. Also, we concentrated on all the details from the finishing, the assembly, etc. And it was very important for us because all these details make our sunglasses higher quality, and this is important because we are writing on the sunglasses, it's handmade in Tunisia, and we want it to be a high quality product. Also, what we focused on is, as we at the beginning, a lot of media talked about VAKAY as the first eyewear company in Tunisia and in North Africa. What was interesting, important for us, is to change this image from just the first eyewear in Tunisia to a fashionable and desired sunglasses. We took a lot of inspiration from Tunisian arts, for example, to make our sunglasses unique and distinguished. For example, we did this concept of sunglasses that we used Islamic architecture patterns, which have 1-5 ratios. And through, for example, this concept, we was invited in New York in Wanted Design, it's a New York fair, in order to show this concept. Also, as a Tunisian company, we think to have a local impact, social impact in our country. So the first month we started, we had the opportunity to help raise funds for a local association that wants us to help save the decors of Star Wars, because the sand was raising up and covering the site. So we didn't hesitate to make special pairs of wooden sunglasses, and something unexpected happened. as this event have international echo because Star Wars fans were all around the world, the story of VAKAY went international too. And we was covered by, for example, Channel 4 in video for makers. Also, we were covered by pages in Kuwait and Brown Book magazine. So what we understand at that point, that we have to continue be inspired with Tunisia and also make all our story more rooted in Tunisia history. So for example, we continue to make not only design that inspired from Tunisian arts, but also we used a lot of beautiful places and sites in Tunisia. So for example, we made a tour all around Tunisia from this old Italian apartment to, we went to a Berber village that is 3,500 years old, and we participated in making Tunisian places famous. And for example, this shooting was covered by an airplane magazine in Air Flight airplane Tunisair, and when we started also making fashion shootings with trying to combining our sunglasses inspired from Berber textures with, for example, this old clothes Tunisian it's called Barnous. This was interesting content for fashion magazines, and they also covered this for VAKAY. After all this period, what we did actually that we did a lot of experiments and learned a lot about the market. Also, it helped us this experiment to improve our process, improve our product, and enhance our marketing strategy. And when I had the opportunity to meet business angel, Tunisian famous Qais Mokhtar, we was ready in order to rapidly scale our business. So at that time, and after we did this, we were able to buy the CNC machine, we were able to improve more our process, and also to have the space for design and relaxing, which I think is important for the team to work in good environment. So, to conclude, I think in VAKAY we faced a lot of limits and difficulties, and all along the way, we always think that this was more a challenge and it was an opportunity for us to be creative and innovative in the way of management and in technical problems too. And we was a lot inspired, for example, from the Toyota history when this famous Japanese company had in the late, in the first 20th century, a lot of competition from American cars industry because in America they had big markets, so they developed Taylorism and they make a standardized product in with mass production, so they cut the prices. But Toyota, as it has a small market and small resources, had to innovate in ways of management in order to make have a different strategy, and they make small batches with machines that are versatile, and they developed the lean manufacturing. And to conclude, I want you finally to ask you the question, what do you think, which is more important, a good idea or a good team? And thank you. Thank you.
Hi, Majdi.
Hi.
So as a startup, what do you think your biggest challenge is now? I mean, it's different than when you first started. What is the challenge now as you go into international markets?
Our first challenge is now we are focusing on expanding our markets internationally. So we have to continue developing our and our creativity in order to make a product that is distinguished. Also, we have to work on marketing and mastering the sales channels. And I think to do that, we have to be in a continuous process of innovation. And this is to be done. We have to have a strong team. And I think that's what we worked on all this period. Yeah.
Are the glasses you're wearing, VAKAY?
Yes, sure.
What happens if you drop them? I mean, a lot of people, you know, get a bit careless with their glasses, or they just fall off, or they, you know, do they break, and can they be fixed? Because that's a major concern for some people.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, we make a lot of tests on resistance of the materials, so they are already strong enough to not break in normal situations. But if it happens, you can glue it and it come back like new. Or if it's a default of guarantee, you will exchange it for free. And if the fault of because you just work like this, you can repair it. Depends if it's the arms, it's less cheaper, etc. Yeah.
Hi. Okay, I wanted to ask, when you first started, how did you gain trust locally? Because sometimes we have the problem that people won't trust a company if it's local rather than if it was international.
Yeah, true. We had this problem. Actually, when we started, there is two kinds of people. I mean, there is ones who said we are too expensive for a Tunisian company. I mean, if we were coming from Europe, they would pay for this price for the same product. And at the same time, we had another kind of people who wanted to have the first Tunisian sunglasses first. And these early adopters helped us to have our sales at the beginning, because as we didn't have a lot of capacity, we already sold all our sunglasses. And in the same time, as we were developing our sales abroad, a lot of Tunisians, when they saw our sunglasses sold in France, in Los Angeles, in London, they started to think, finally, it's a good product because others trust it. Yeah.
Hello. Hello. Can you tell us more about when you start your marketing and advertising in a global way or international international way? Have you collaborated, مثلا, with some famous magazines like Vogue or maybe Style Arabia if you target the region? Mm. Can you tell us about your steps to expand and how you use marketing and advertising in each steps? Start from Tunisia to Arab world, then Europe and US.
Yes.
Or other markets.
Yeah. Okay. Actually, when we started, we didn't have a lot of money even to improve fast our process. So we decided to focus first on the product. But in the same time, in marketing, what we try to do is to create the content that media will use to talk about VAKAY. For example, as it succeeded with the Save Mosespa action, we also had the same thing with Airplane magazine, and we also concentrated on create the content, and naturally a lot of magazines use this content to talk about VAKAY. Also, we had another opportunity, because as in Tunisia we had a revolution, a lot of media internationally was looking for what's happening in Tunisia. And some of them also are looking for what is happening in the good way. So for example, we have NTV from Germany who made a reportage on VAKAY. Also Al Jazeera talked about VAKAY and Monocle in London, and all this was for free. We just concentrated on creating the content, yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Here in the front. Thank you very much for the talk.
Yeah, thank you.
My question is, what is the main issue you faced when you manufactured locally?
Actually, as we were the first to make an industry of eyewear, well, the most difficult thing is to find the machines, to find the raw materials, because there was no ecosystem. So we had to build this ecosystem. We worked a lot of suppliers to, and we developed with them the tools and the parts we needed to make our sunglasses. And maybe I think the most difficult thing was this ecosystem that is missing. But now as we started, we already started, we feel responsible because now we are the only company who produce sunglasses in Tunisia. So we started to collaborate with a lot of fashion designer in Tunisia and to make collaborations in order to give them opportunity to create their sunglasses, but also for VAKAY, it's interesting to discover new ideas and new design. Yeah.
Hi, Majdi.
Hi.
I want to focus a little bit on the team aspect. Mm. A few things I've picked up on and I thought are, I'd like your insight. You said that all four of you quit your jobs to do this, and I was wondering how would four people come together to, did you arrive at this decision collectively or was someone a bit skeptic? And also how would you solve conflict within the team? You collect a lot of feedback, but then didn't conflict rise on whether you should act on this feedback or not, and what would the solution be? So to me that's very interesting, how you guys work, the dynamic of how you guys work together.
It's true that we all resigned off our different jobs, but also the first months, also we worked without salary, so we was living with our measly means. This was really difficult, but we, from the beginning, we believed very strong in what we are doing. So this is what I think helped us move on, and I think. In the team to be successful, you need also a chemistry that boosts the team. And for us, it was this idea, this common goal to create the first Tunisian eyewear. And for conflicts, it happens, but I mean, we always put it in the frame of everyone in the team wants to progress. Maybe we can have different opinions, but finally we have to find a common solution. I mean, yeah. Thank you.
I want to ask you, does it get easier if you finish the first stages of your business, or does it get harder?
You mean if you, now things are harder?
Yeah, how to remain success.
Yeah, successful. I think we just faces new challenges, and as we things changes our challenges too. Every time we have to change also our organization and the way we work together and the way we do things. So what is important is I think to be flexible and to have a flexible organization. But I can't say if it's harder or less harder, but it just changed, and we always have new challenges, and we have deadlines and objectives, and we have to work on it, and we always have to work. I don't say hard, but smarter, as smart. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Majdi.
Thank you very much.